Hi friends, this is Leela. Welcome to my channel. Up to now we have seen how to make the HTTP post request, get request and delete request we have seen, right? In the Angular through the HTTP client we have seen. Now let's move into the next concepts, that is nothing but configuring of the HTTP. So first one what we will try to see is about how to send the HTTP headers. Okay, so for example where we will be trying to see is in some APIs, some authorized APIs, so they will be asking us to send the authorization key. In the request address, they will be asking us to send the authorization keys to the as an HTTP address they will be asking. And you will be having to send to some custom headers and all those things also. You should be sending in the HTTP API calls. So those type of headers, how you will be sending in the HTTP request, you will see now in this video. So before going to this video, if you are coming first time to my channel, please do support me by subscribing to my channel so that I'll be posting more and more front end development courses. And now coming to this video. So here what we will try to see is, for example, here in this example, now here we are trying to call the post.json. That means we are trying to get the post data. Now here we are having the request address. So these are the request address which will be sent automatically by the HTTP. By the browser itself. Okay, these are all sent by the browser. Now I want to send some extra headers to the server. So how can I send? So in the HTTP, it's very easy. We can send through simple only. So how we can send is, for example, if it is a GET request, okay, you will be having the second argument or otherwise POST request. So whatever the request it will be, the last argument will be the headers only, sending the headers only. So for example, here the POST request. So first one will be the URL, and here you can have an object. Okay, in this object you will be having set of object. One is the headers, so you will be able to see the top here options. In this headers, observe, params and all those things will be there. So first we need to send the headers here. So if you want to send the headers, how can I send headers? And here I will be calling new HTTP headers. Okay, HTTP headers. So this HTTP headers, it need to be imported from the Angular common HTTP. So it should be imported, and I am creating an object HTTP headers. So in this HTTP headers, we will be sending the object. So what are the headers you want to send? You will be sending the objects. Now normally what you will say, headers is nothing but what we can say is it's a key value pair only. So if you go and if you see here in the browser, all the time you will be able to see that key and a value. Accept language is the key, and ENUS everything is the value. So headers is nothing but a key value pair. So here also you can send the object, so that will be key value pair only. So I will be writing something like custom header. Okay, so whatever the name you want you can give, and here I am writing it as Leela. So this is the header I am sending to the HTTP request, get request I am sending. So whatever the headers you want, you can send as many headers you can want, you can send. Now let's try to check the output. So if I try to check the output here, if I refresh the code, and now if I try to see here, and in the request headers, if you see, you will be able to see this one custom header Leela, you will be able to see. So that means we are successfully sending the headers to the server. So in the server, they will be using this header and they will be checking that request whether the header is coming correctly or not. They will be checking. That is another process. So how to send the headers through the HTTP request is the main criteria. So mainly what we will be trying to do is we will be trying to send the API key, authorization key, and these are the things for the API authorization and all the things. We'll be sending the headers like this. Okay, so the server will be expecting the headers. So send me the authorization key or something like that. So we need to send the data same like this, headers, and we need to send authorization, and we need to send the key like this. Okay, in this way we will be sending the headers to the HTTP. The same thing happens in the post also. So the post, after the post data, you can send the same thing, object, and you will be having the headers, and you will be sending same thing, new HTTP headers. Okay, new HTTP headers, and here also you will be sending an object. So I can say custom header, you can say post Leela or something like this. Okay, so whatever the thing you want. Now if I do the post request also, the same thing happens. So nothing wrong in it. So for example, so let it refresh. And if I try to refresh this code, and if I try to add here the content, and it will try to post this one. And if I go and if I check the request headers, and you will be, this is the post request, right? And afterwards you will be getting the data, and here in this one you will be able to see the custom header post Leela. We are sending the data, see. So in this way we can send the HTTP headers to post and get, and whatever the requests you want, you can send the data. So this is about how to sending the headers to the server. So if you have any doubts or any suggestions, please post the comments below to this video. And if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.